That's my Lord, Allah, the creator of us all. الحمد لله الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا على نعمة الإسلام. فهذه النعمة العظيمة التي أنقذنا الله بها من الظلمات إلى النور ومن علينا بها بخير خلقه محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. ثم أما بعد, my dear brothers and sisters, I would like to counsel myself and every one of you here with the God consciousness, taqwa of Allah the Almighty. Because Allah the Almighty said in the Holy Quran, O you who believe, fear Allah as He should be feared, and die not except being in the state of Iman. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. According to the Holy Quran, taqwa is one of the most important treasures in this world. A person, an intellectual person, he will think deeply about saving this great treasure, the treasure of taqwa. Abu Dharr al-Ghifari radiallahu anhu, a great companion, who said that I love the hunger, and I love the illness, and I love the death. Then he said, the people said, why, O Sahabi, O companion? He said, because if I become hungry, then this soften my heart. And if I fall ill, then this reduce, and this wipes my sins off. And if I die, then I meet Allah the Almighty. Another important quotation from a great Khalifa, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, rahimahullah, who said, لا تكن ممن يلعن إبليس. Do not be one of those people who actually curse Iblis, Shaytan, in public, and he follows Shaytan in secret. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with another year, a year of good deeds. Alhamdulillah, we've tried our best to do as much as we could for Allah the Almighty. I ask Allah the Almighty to accept this minor ibadah, worship that we have presented in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, my dear brothers and sisters, we are on the 6th of Sha'ban, and we are towards the end of the year of good deeds. We are on the 6th of Sha'ban, and we are coming to an end of the year of good deeds. Now, there is an important hadith which is recorded by Imam Al-Ahmad wa Nasa'i with a sound chain on the authority of Usama ibn Zayd radiallahu anhuma. قُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. This great companion is saying, we asked Messenger of Allah the Almighty, O Messenger of Allah, we do not see you fasting as much as you fast in the month of Sha'ban. Then Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he said, because this is a month when a lot of people, they're neglectful, they're heedless, and this is a month which falls in between Rajab and Ramadan, and that is the month when our good deeds are presented in front of Allah the Almighty, who is the Lord of the universe. And Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he said, and I would love my good deeds to be presented in front of Allah the Almighty while I am fasting. On the authority of Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha, the mother of the believers, she said, ما رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم استكمل صيام شهر. I haven't seen Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, fasting every day of a month except the month of Ramadan. Meaning he would fast every day of month of Ramadan. وما رأيت في شهر أكثر منه صياما في شعبان. And I haven't seen Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, fasting as frequently as month of Sha'ban. Meaning he would miss some time, but he would fast most of the Sha'ban. Now, according to these hadith, we can easily understand that we are actually at the end of a year, at the end of the year of good deeds. Now, everything in this world, every profession, every field has its ending, and the end of the good deeds, the year of the good deeds, and the ending is the Sha'ban. So there is something that we need to really look into ourselves, like, what have we done in the previous year? How much good deeds have we done? How much amal as-salih we have done for Allah the Almighty? And also we need to really look into our good deeds and bad deeds, because Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu عنه he said that حاسبوا أنفسكم قبل أن تحاسبوا. You must account yourself, you must evaluate yourself before you are accounted by Allah the Almighty, and also you must weigh your good deeds before Allah the Almighty weighs your good deed on the Day of Judgment. Because if that is too late, then that will be a very difficult, it will be very severe. So you might as well account yourself before Allah the Almighty start accounting. So believing brothers and sisters in Islam, I've mentioned that every profession, every field, like the economical year, the educational year, academic year, every field has its end of the year. And as Muslim, as believers, our end of the year is this month. This is a month where we need to really sit and we really need to think, we really need to realize and ponder upon our good deeds and bad deeds. How much crimes have you made last year? How much sins we've committed last year? How many theft probably we've committed? How many adultery we've committed? How many? How much haram sustenance we have earned last year? We need to really think about all those things. We need to sit and speak to ourselves. This is a month of taking some firm resolution, firm decision. This is a month of U-turn. This is a month we need to really come to a realization. Until how long we are going to play in this world? Until how long we'll be stuck in the web of this world? Because this world is really a web. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent us to this world in order to worship Him. But what we have done is that we got stuck into the web of this world. There are so much amusement, there are so much destructive moods in this world where we got stuck into the dunya. So we need to really think until how long we'll be playing and until how long we'll be heedless. Because Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, he said that an-nasu niyam, the human being are asleep. They're asleep. They're in a deep sleep. فَإِذَا مَاتُوا انْتَبَهُوا. If they die, then that's when they really wake up. That's when they wake up and they realize and they understand what they have done. Allah the Almighty says in Surah Al-Fajr, يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانِ. There will be a day when every human soul will realize. He will realize what he did in this world. But on that day, the Day of Judgment, his realization won't benefit him. Because that is going to be too late. يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانُ وَأَنَّا لَهُ الذِّكْرَ. يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي. The man will say, alas, if I only have done something for Allah, يا ليتني قدمت لحياتي فيوم, then I wouldn't be punished today. I wouldn't get this punishment the way I'm going to be punished today, and I wouldn't be tied just the way I'm being tied today. ولا يوثق وثاقه أحد. And then يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة, Allah the Almighty will order the satisfied soul, the best of the nafs, مطمئنة, يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة, ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية. Return to your Lord, you are pleased and your Lord is pleased. راضية مرضية. فادخلي في عبادي. Enter amongst my honored and beloved slaves. وادخلي جنتي. And enter into paradise. I do not mean to say that we totally need to refrain and stay away from this world. No, we have to live in this world. But at the same time, we have to remain our connection and attachment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just the way a boat needs water. But if water goes into the boat, then it sinks. Similarly, we have to live in this world. We have to be dutiful to the people and to fellow human beings in this world, but at the same time we have to keep our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I really wanted to say that this month of Sha'ban is a month of firm resolution. We need to take some serious decisions. We need to make a U-turn, otherwise and it will be too late, and then our tawbah, our repentance, our regret will never benefit anything. Believing brothers and sisters in Islam, we are going to receive two important events very soon. Number one is the 15th night of Sha'ban. On the authority of Imam al-Bayhaqi, he mentioned in his book that if the 15th night of Sha'ban comes, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he comes to the lowest sky and he asks and he forgives the believers, and also he leave the non-believers. وَيَدَعُوا أَحْلَ الْحِقْ, and the people, those who have grudge and enmity, Allah doesn't forgive these people until they leave this حِقْد and حَسَد and jealousy and whatever disease they have in their hearts. Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullah alayhi, he considers this night as a night of fawail, these merits and virtues in this night. And also Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah, he said that this was one of the nights when our dua supplication would be accepted. Also, we are going to receive a great month, the month of Ramadan. We really need to start preparing, start planning. Unfortunately, we see people, I have found people actually start to buy the Eid clothes before they actually prepare and plan for Ramadan. They're already buying, they're doing shopping for Eid, subhanAllah. We need to prepare for Ramadan. We need to engage ourselves in learning Holy Quran, in studying Holy Quran, and also in teaching Holy Quran. These are the months of Quran right in front of us. Important decisions will be made in the month of Ramadan. Our next year, all fates will be decided in the month of Ramadan. So we might as well be careful and make best out of the month of Ramadan. May Allah the Almighty give us stability to practice upon what has been said. If I've said anything wrong, then it's from me and Shaytan. And if I've said anything right, it's from Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. اللهم كن لنا ولا تكن علينا اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا وأصلح ذات بيننا اللهم اجمع كلمتنا اللهم وحد صفوفنا اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين أعز إسلامنا وانصر المسلمين واهد الناس أجمعين اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وألهمنا اجتنابه وارض اللهم عن جميع صحابة رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين خاصة أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي والحسن والحسين ومعاوية وجميع صحابة رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين وعنا معهم بمنك وكرمك وجودك يا إله الكون يا رب العالمين. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم وأقم الصلاة.